Hello everyone, today I want to show you how to use Ulti.Media Converter to do this kind of effect. Turn this image into this image fully automatically. My idea is to create a preset for square covers to be used for urban images. So first of all, let's look for urban style images. I subscribe to FreePic, which is a site that with a subscription allows you to download images, photos, vector artwork, etc. Let's look for maybe something with graffiti or with a wall. Here it is, the image we were using earlier. Let's download it. Let's create a folder and let's put it inside. At this point, open Ulti.Media Converter 2 and create a new preset. Go here, in the bottom right-hand corner, click New Preset and call it Urban. Leave the image blank for now because we will fill it with the image we're going to create. Go into the settings and specify image type and leave JPEG. For now let's leave everything unchanged, same size and as 80% quality, because that's more than fine. What's important, we need to apply segmentation, which is to extract the main subject using the alpha channel. This way we will separate the subject from the background. Before go any further, let's change something in the name panel. As a prefix, put the name urban cover and as a suffix the date. Finally, in the workflow files, choose to save in the covers subfolder. Click OK and then look for urban. This is our preset. Let's try dragging this image up here and see what happens. The covers folder is created, as we said. Let's see in covers what happens. Here it is. The subject has been separated from the background, but the background remains completely white. Let's go and edit the preset so that we add the same image as before. In the editing panel, put use original image as background. If we do that, let's see what we get. Well, we will actually get the same image as before. What we want to do is color the background black and white. And how do we do that? It is done by applying a LUT, which is a color correction. What LUT do we apply? Let's look for it among all the ones we have. We'll use this application, which is LUT Explorer, which allows us to see which LUT to use. You can choose any one. We want to do a black and white thing, so we can choose either this one, which has high contrast, or this one, which has lower contrast. Choose this one. Show in Finder. We want to use this LUT, and let's drag it in here. At this point, let's go all the way through again. Drag the image to urban and see what happens. There, the effect is already more interesting now. The subject is colored and the background is black and white. We can go further, though, by applying full color correction to the whole image. Let's go back and edit our preset and apply a final LUT to the whole thing. Which one? Let's choose one, for example this one, that greatly increases the contrast. Or we can choose this one, which is a bit old-fashioned. But I prefer this one, which increases the contrast and also the saturation. Let's show it in the Finder. Let's use this LUT and drag it over here. We see that the original background of the image uses this color tinting. and instead this color correction is applied to everything after the process of separating the subject from the background is done. Let's try it one more time. And here's what the effect is. Very contrasty with the subject colored and the background with a more deep black and white. But we want to get a square image, so go back into the preset settings and instead of leaving same starting size, put 2400 by 2400 pixels, which is the resolution of podcast covers. And to get the image to be centered on the subject, we go to this setting, the power crop. Turn it on, so that the image will be cropped. So that the main subject keeps at least 10% space on the edge. This 10%. You can also go to 15% for example. Let's try one more time. The processing time is longer, but this is the final effect. Finally, mnemonically, let's change the image of this tile. Go to Name and Info and drag this image here, to use as the background. And write a brief description. Let's see how this point, this preset, behaves with other images. Note that sometimes the system also considers some parts of the background as the subject. In this case, you can simply go here into the preset settings and specify extract people. Suppose we have this logo and we want to apply it to all our images. But making sure that the app will put the logo behind the subject and in front of the background. Nothing could be easier. Reopen our preset and in editing add the backdrop and load this logo. The logo is square, we leave fill and with the opacity at 80% to see how it works. Let's try again. And there it is, our logo stuck behind the main subject. And we can repeat the same operation with the other covers. And here are the results. If you are very satisfied with your preset, you can also decide to submit it to the bazaar, specifying your information and uploading it. If the preset is approved, you will find it in the preset bazaar. Here it is. Well, that's it for today. I would like to remind you that you can comment on this video for more information, insights, and requests for new tutorials. Subscribe to the channel and turn on the little bell to be notified when new videos or tutorials are uploaded.